do mosaics. Now just that small, you can see some pieces here. So these are just the samples that we do. We mostly do commission works. We can work for your, like anywhere where you put tiles, we can do mosaics. So this is one small work that I have got. So I'll just show you how we work. These are our tools. This is called the tile nipper, and this is a wheel nipper. So these are the two tools that we use when we are working with the tiles. So for example, when I'm doing this flower, I will just, let's keep it like this. So this is the color that I'm using. This is how we cut. Anyone can come and try them, please. Feel free to try these. And that's how we cut our pieces. And every piece is then fitted. See, like now if I have to... So this is how we take the pieces and we start putting them together like this.
Just filling up.
This is not filling up.
Okay.
It's basically you have to choose what color you're putting where. So it definitely is, but it's like a jigsaw puzzle where you have to see what piece fits where and looks beautiful as
so
well.
So you cut it according to the yes. shape you like.
Yes. We have to cut it according to the shape that is needed. So mosaic is a lot of planning. It doesn't happen randomly like other paintings. Where we start painting and okay, I didn't like this color and I just, put another color and I do it. No. In mosaic, we have to plan from the very beginning. Because any wrong thing that happens, you can't scrape the tiles off.
It's a waste.
So it's a waste and then it can't happen. You waste a lot of stuff. So you have to plan. So here you see, I have already done the drawings.
Yeah.
And I do my breakup accordingly. I'll take a pen and I'll see where do I want. I've been doing it for so many years, so I am not drawing the lines now because it's there in my mind. But when we start, then we break. See, I have already done like a little breakup here I've done. So we break it up and then accordingly we cut the pieces and we put them together on this. I'll show you.
Do you leave a gap on purpose?
Yes, the gap will come.
Okay.
Because the beauty of mosaic is the cracks.
Yeah.
And cracks, when the cracks are filled, is when it shows. Like, for example, you see here.
Yeah.
So, if there is no black here, it is not going to look beautiful. Because the beauty of mosaic is how you crack it and how you make it, So, every crack has, you have to plan it. It just doesn't happen. Like, when we are doing the birds or when we are doing any element, so we study it. That how are the strokes going? If there's a bird, then how are the feathers? Which side the feathers are going? So accordingly, then we draw and we cut it. Like when you do the brush strokes also. So the same way, like in this frangipani, how the petals are going, how the veins are going. So you have to study the whole 3D part of an element and then do it. Same here, if you see the tree. So the tree has these cracks. This is the tree which is, it's called the crocodile tree. This is the national tree of Goa, by the way. You've seen it has cracks. So it almost looks like the crocodile.
Mati.
Not Mati, I think.
No, it's not Mati also.
It's not Mati. It's a
Patharpod.
It's Patharpod, I
thought. I think it's Patharpod.
So then we have to study that how is the skin, how is everything. The same is with the birds now. Like here. So this, we have to study the bird very closely, how are the feathers going, how are the scales going, and then we have to work. So there's a lot of detailed study that goes into it.
And how do you round it off? If you want to round off the end of the
So we cut, this is the cutting that we do.
With that?
With the same nipper. So I can show you a little bit.
There's no sanding or smoothening or something?
No. Because if we start doing sanding and smoothening, it'll take us a long time to finish. So we have to be expert in making...
And so you don't only use tiles, you use some other things too?
Yes. See, this is the circle. It's just with the nipper. So we just use this and we cut anything. We can cut a petal with this.
Can you explain about this project of the bridge?
So the bridge project was given to us by GSIDC. We were working with GSIDC and there was a competition that was there. So eventually we gave one sample to them and that's how we got it. Now here, the birds of Goa, it's not just about the birds of Goa. We've done a complete research on the birds of Goa. from the marshland birds to the jungle birds. So one side of the bridge is like these ones.
It is in Panjimbar. It is
yes,
there.
This is the bridge, footover bridge, which connects Mala to Pato.
Okay.
So it used to be blue in color earlier. So this has been renovated. It was renovated 2.5 years back. So one side is the marshland birds. This is the marshland area. And the other side is the jungle birds. So there's a complete research that we did that where, what is the habitat of that particular bird? Do they stay close to the water or are they on up in above the water? Same is with the jungle birds, whether they live in the shrubs or they are up high on the trees. So if you actually, the detail that has been written about each bird has actually been, we've literally worked very hard on it. And then eventually the whole layout was made for these birds. And anything else? I am very bad at presentations. Huh? This
now
is like really random.
There are 50 birds, I believe.
No, we have 70 birds. Around 72 birds.
You made? In
yes. We made 72 birds.
Where around?
It's there. Oh, it's there. It's already there. Yeah, yeah. It's been 2.5 years. It has already seen 2 monsoons.
Yeah.
No, mosaic and this thing.
Have to clean your mosaic after every monsoon?
We don't have to. That's the client's thing. That's not, we don't do that. Once our job is done, we are out of it.
And so, they can say maybe I can action that.